The Memorial Day and Labor Day holidays bookend a summer of lost opportunity. The United States failed to stamp out the virus before the fall. This is expected to bring new dangers with the start of the school year, flu season, and cooler weather that will drive people indoors. Nearly 30 million Americans continue to rely on some form of unemployment assistance, even though jobs have come back for the highest wage earners. The number of permanent job losses rose to 2.9 million in June. Companies are moving from temporary layoffs to permanent job cuts. The University of Washington, one of several sources used by the White House, is now projecting 410,000 COVID-19 deaths in the United States by January 2021. Government funding expires September 30th. To avoid an election shutdown, Pelosi and Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin tentatively agreed to use a short-term spending bill to avoid a government shutdown. The Senate returns next week. Before this next round of Congress, Senator Schumer had a call with his caucus last week and told them to stay united, as they did during the previous $2.2 trillion CARES Act. Senate Republicans, though, are working to craft a smaller relief bill, and they are eyeing a potential floor vote next week when the Senate is back. The new Senate Republican proposal is expected to include $300 in weekly federal unemployment benefits through the end of December, funding for the Paycheck Protection Program, $105 billion for education, and of course, liability protections for companies. The bill would also provide billions to the United States Postal Service by converting an existing $10 billion loan into a grant. But with no money for rental assistance, health care, pension aid, no money for nutrition, and no money for state and local services, the census, or safe elections, McConnell and Senate Republicans will be making another unacceptable and ineffective attempt at providing relief. The Trump administration made public a new nationwide ban on the eviction of tenants. This is actually half-ass help. It helps landlords without aid, and renters still owe the money. It would put the stability of the entire rental housing sector in danger. The chief actuary of the Social Security Administration just released an analysis of Trump's planned cuts to the Social Security Administration. Under Trump's plan, because of his proposed payroll tax cut, Social Security will become permanently depleted by the middle of 2023. Don't let it happen. Joe Biden will protect Social Security. I'm Britton Lofton, and that's your week ahead.